All right, so today we're going to take a look at the Boss AC2 acoustic simulator. And this is one that I knew that I was going to get to eventually. And I think this is going to be an interesting video here. So this is a pretty misunderstood Boss product. I've seen it called the worst or in the ranking for the worst or some of that stuff. And I really feel like it's just that people are misunderstanding this. I did pick this one up used at a place that sells used books, music, games, guitar equipment and stuff, and has a pretty generous return policy. Just thinking that I might give it a try, see what it was all about, return it if I didn't like it, and I hung on to it. I thought that it was actually kind of cool and unique for what it's doing here. So I wanted to start with what I think people do wrong with it, and that's having it in their effects chain. So I'm doing Telecaster into the AC2 and then into the simplifier, and I'm using the Vox setting this time. I've got a little bit of gain on it. This is my gainy signal. So I think people plug it in like that, and then you might hit that. Mean, that's a sound, but so that might be one problem with it. Now I'm obviously running that into a distorted amp, so I could clean it up some though. Let's balance this out, bring down the preamp, let's bring up the overall volume. That still works, but it's still running through a guitar amp. Or in this case, the simplifier acting like a Vox. Let's hear what it sounds like on the Fender, on the Marshall. Now that's how it would sound with that on. That's definitely more electric guitar-like, having it like this. And this is, got the acoustic elements, but it's still being processed like a guitar signal. So that I think is a big part of the problem. Before I get into the correct way, let's just run over some of the knobs here. We got the level, then you have the body, which is gonna determine how bassy it is and how resonant. The top is going to control kind of the treble and also kind of the harmonic quality of it. And then you have four different modes. You have standard, jumbo, which I guess is just kind of like a beefier sound, enhanced, which has kind of a little bit of ambience to it, and then piezo, which is a different type of pickup that you might find on acoustic guitars. It's actually a contact pickup that they can use that instead of having a regular pickup like you would have on an electric guitar. So like a nylon string guitar might have a electric guitar might have a piezo pickup instead of like what you might see with a regular acoustic. So let's check this out real quick. We have two outputs. So we have the output and then one that says EG out. Now that would be electric guitar out. So if I out, excuse me, I'm gonna cut out all the pops if I can. If I plug into the EG out with the effect on, I get nothing. With the effect off, I get that. Okay. So that's actually a clue to how you're intended to use this. Now you can have it on your pedal board and running through the amp and everything, but I think what Boss really intended you to do was have it plugged in like this. So the EG out, you're running a signal to the amplifier when it's off. But with this, the output, if you're using these, what they really want you to do is actually go to some kind of a DI or something. Now I'm using the DI Plus by Ultrasound that I did a video on the other day. That's what I just plugged into. So what you're hearing there, that's the simplifier sound. Let's go back to the Vox and give us a little bit more gain so it's easier to hear the difference. All right, so no acoustic simulator. Now watch this. Now, know if you can hear that. You know, if you're listening to it with headphones, you might hear it a bit better, but let me do that again one more time. Also might need to double check. No. Close enough, whatever. All right, so again, with it off, this is running through the simplifier. So I've got this going on a stereo channel in my interface, but then I've got another channel that's just going from my DI Plus. So when I engage this, no more signal coming from the simplifier, that goes away. I've got all this, so let's really use this to mess around with the settings now. Let's start on the standard mode, and you can see with the top, that's the body. So if I have it all the way down, very thin sound, obviously, but to me that's much more authentic acoustic. And I'm sure there is a little bit of string bleed coming through my microphone here, but just forgive that. It does sound pretty authentic to me there. And bring up the body. That's probably a bit much. Yeah, that's a bit much, but the idea is you can kind of dial it into your specific guitar there. Let's do the same thing with the top end. That's minimum. That's max. So it's not just a high-end control, it's also kind of that harmonic. Too. Let's just kind of dial it back. We don't have to be max or minimum on anything. I think it sounds just fine straight up there. So that's the standard mode. Let's hear jumbo. That was switched over to jumbo. Hearing that it's kind of it's different, but it's also familiar. So again, piezo is more like a contact pickup than a magnetic pickup like you might get with some other instruments. So that's pretty cool. And you know, not doing anything special with the DI Plus that I'm plugged into there with it. Off again. It would be interesting if they had included some kind of a blend knob where you could actually find a balance between the two outputs that you could use there, but obviously, this is something that's been around, and I know there's a lot of different options for like acoustic preamps, but that's not what this is. It's not acoustic preamp, it's acoustic simulator. So, again, I know that this is not the most popular pedal, but I really think that a lot of that just has to do with people's misunderstanding of it and just throwing it into their effects chain and thinking that it's gonna do what they would expect, you know, go from that to that. So what you might try doing if you want to incorporate something like this into your pedal board would be just go ahead and plug it in and have the EG be the regular way that you're plugging it in, and then you could run just straight from the output into, say, your PA if you're practicing at a practice space, or you might even consider getting like your own DI box, something that you could have on your pedal board. That way you could just ask the sound man for an XLR caper, XLR cable, plug that in, and then just have them do a little bit of adjusting from the soundboard, or you could even do a little bit of that tweaking from here. But it's probably a good idea to at least let them know what's going on. Don't need to stretch this out too long or anything. I think I've kind of showed what I was wanting to try to showcase with this, so I'll wrap it up. But thank you guys very much, and I will see you in another video soon. Thanks. Mm-hmm.